Today, these ideas first proposed by a man who thought that child rape could be loving and who performed a years-long sexually abusive experiment on two unwilling children who later went on to kill themselves are taken as gospel truth. When it comes to the concept of gender and gender constructs, there's no better place to start than Dr. John Money. How many people have heard of Dr. John Money? Okay, good number. He's a prominent psychologist and sexologist. Money was one of the early pioneers of gender theories that are currently taught in grade schools all the way up to universities and beyond. Among the first to take the word gender out of the realm of grammar and apply it to people, because before guys like John Money came along, there was no such thing as a person having a gender. Words have gender. People have sex. There was no reason for a person to have a gender and a sex because they mean the same thing. But not according to Dr. John Money. He coined the terms gender role, gender identity, sexual orientation. That all came from him. A professor at York University recently published a book labeling John Money the man who invented gender. So suffice it to say, he was an extremely influential man, and anyone who propagates left-wing gender theory is parroting at least some of John Money's ideas, whether they realize it or not. Most of the time they don't. Now that fact ought to be troubling to gender theory proponents because John Money was, among other things, a fraud, a lunatic, and a pedophile. Along with more conventionally degenerate views, his advocacy for open marriages and group sex, for example, Money was also, as a not very critical article in Salon puts it, ambivalently supportive of pedophilia. So drawing a distinction between what he called sadistic pedophilia and affectional pedophilia, Money held that a relationship between a grown man and a child who really love each other isn't necessarily disordered. There isn't necessarily anything wrong with it. As long as they really love each other, of course. So, jumping ahead now to 1965, the birth of twins Bruce and Brian Raymer. Now, these boys are born healthy, except for a condition called phimosis, which affects the foreskin. It was decided, wrongly it turns out, that the best way to treat the condition was circumcision. But Bruce's procedure went horribly wrong, and his penis was essentially burned off. After several months of grasping for answers, Bruce's parents eventually decided to take him to Johns Hopkins in Baltimore to see the renowned Dr. John Money after they saw some interviews with him on TV. Now, the good doctor, eager to prove the legitimacy of his theory that gender is a product of environment and culture, recommended that Bruce undergo a sex reassignment surgery. So before the boy turned two, the deed had been done. His testicles were removed, some crude approximation of female genitalia were formed, and Money instructed the parents to raise him as a girl from that day forward, never to tell him his real identity. This should work perfectly, right? If gender is just a social construct, should be no problem at all. Now, the Reimer parents tried to follow Money's advice, but they found that Bruce, you know, was still Bruce, even if they called him Brenda, did everything in their power to preserve his fragile and false female identity. Crazy thing is, he was a male, and he still was. You know, gender is a construct, though, they were told. Why should a boy raised as a girl still have boyish tendencies? But his boyishness came through in spite of Money's theories. And Money tried to drive the point home more. He would have the boys come back. They attended regular therapy sessions with Money. For therapy, Money sometimes instructed the boys to disrobe and inspect each other's genitals. Sometimes they were made to simulate sex acts on each other. On at least one occasion, nude photos of the boys were taken for reasons that were never quite clear. Ultimately, Money was convinced that his project had been a smashing success, and he published a lot of books and things and articles saying what a great success it was. It was not a success. The female identity never took hold for Bruce. He was confused and miserable, on the verge of suicide, until as a teen, his mother finally told him the truth, that he's really a boy. Bruce chose immediately to transition back to a boy, taking the name of David this time. He underwent another reassignment surgery, this time to try to reclaim his true self. He felt better for a time, but neither he nor his brother lived happily ever after, to put it mildly. Their experience as John Money's lab rats and playthings had damaged them both irrevocably. David would go on to speak out against Money, first anonymously and then publicly. Eventually, he even got married, but all was not well. The first twin whose life ended tragically early was Brian. In 2002, at the age of 36, he overdosed on antidepressants. 2 years later, David drove to a grocery store parking lot with a sawed-off shotgun and shot himself in the head. Now, their deaths will go down in history as suicides, but the reality is that they were murdered by Dr. John Money. the father of modern gender theory. The guy who came up with a lot of the stuff that you guys are learning in school today. Now, I wish this was all just a bit of, you know, tragic and disturbing historical trivia. Unfortunately, though, John Money's experiment, although it was a catastrophic failure and his theories were dramatically disconfirmed by his own experiments, he still achieved a victory on the cultural battlefield. Today, these ideas, first proposed by a man who thought that child rape could be loving and who performed a years-long sexually abusive experiment on two unwilling children who later went on to kill themselves, are taken as gospel truth